Welcome everybody to my Venetian stay. After staying at the Bellagio, I'm so lucky to do this. Oh, it's gonna be a good one. Ooh la la. Let me turn on the lights. All right, here's a standard two queen bedroom at the Venetian. Beautiful bathroom. Walk-in shower, heck yeah. Separate tub. I like the design of this, the decor, better than the Bellagio of the, ooh, they got a TV in here. Very nice. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I know these are all suite rooms, so obviously it's gonna be bigger than Bellagio's, but the coloring and the lighting is very important to me, and I got, ooh, two TVs. This looks like a, I want to say 60 inch, pretty big. Here's the separate that pulls out. And here's our view. What do we got? Oh, the pool, nice. Oh, that's nice. See the mountains over there. Pool is pretty crowded and pretty small and flat. I'm sure this is the Venetian side. I'm sure the Palazzo side also has a separate pool, so we gotta check that out. Very nice. A desk, so you can sit there and study. Beautiful. All right, room-wise, better than Bellagio, as I suspected. You know, I have stayed here a while ago. So definitely the room. Location, Bellagio is better, but then center strip. Let's see. Oh, bathrobe and slippers. Customer service was really good too here. The check-in process. I am very pleased with this. Coloring, warm coloring, decor. I don't like modern, you know? And Bellagio has a more modern feel to it, the room. Beautiful. Is the bed plush. Let's see. I could tell the bed is not as plush. It's more firm than Bellagio's, definitely. But it's not cheap or anything. It's just more firm. Wow. All right. This is gonna be an awesome stay. Can't wait. Grand Lux over here, right downstairs is my 24 hours. It's the best 24 hours food you'll get, you know, in Vegas. Just love Grand Lux. Yeah, I'm really, really happy with this. That's for sure. All right. The TV, I can't really even get my hand in here, and it doesn't come out or anything, so it's going to be very tough to connect any video game systems and stuff. You know, let me see this one. Yeah, this one is easier to get to. Oh yeah, right there. This one's easier. Let's see if there's any space for us to put our stuff in. There's a little shelf up here. Okay. This new place called Donatique has opened and they're offering complimentary donuts today. Pretty nice in here. Offer a lot of different items. Wow. Which ones were the complimentary ones? Okay. Let me see here. That's tiramisu, pistachio.
$9 for that. That one. Here's the donutique, the blueberry donut. Look how fancy. Wow. I mean, it better be for like $9. Luckily, you got it for free today.
Here's the cross section of the blueberry donut with the blueberry jam filling inside. Interesting. Looks really good.
It is very good, very fresh, tasty. It tastes natural too, like the blueberry filling tastes like blueberry, you know? Not like fake.
Gonna order some Grand Lux to go take it to the room. Here is the Cobb salad, chicken on the side, and the eggs any way you want it with hash browns. Three eggs.
Wow, that donut was really good. That was a really good donut. Tasted very fresh. The meal from the food that we got from Grand Lux. The ranch, their Caesar dressing, everything was fantastic. That was really, really good.
Here's the strawberry cheesecake donut from Donutique. Here's the chocolate, rich chocolate donut. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. All right, here's the inside of the strawberry cheesecake. You got the cross section of the banana cream pie. Ooh, baby. And that's just, there's no filling on this one.
That was really good. The banana cream pie is the best one. Very fresh. The dough is all fresh. The taste is perfect. Number two, I think, would be the blueberry one. Number three would be this strawberry. And number four, the chocolate one, because it's pretty plain. There's no filling or anything, and the chocolate is just the glaze, you know? But wow, really, really good, really fresh. And all tastes like an organic, like not artificial flavoring.
Water pressure's not bad, pretty good. They have some of the best shampoo here. It smells like roses. I love this song.
Watching two TVs at the same time. Just need to put on something that I actually want to watch though.
Grand Lux Cafe at the Venetian.
The wedge Caesar salad, one of the best salads ever, ever, ever. Ah, so good, so good.
We got the three-way salmon. Ooh-wee, asparagus, mushroom, green beans, mashed potatoes,
a side of sauteed mushrooms.
Oh man, so good.
Here is the chicken Madeira with the pasta.
What's going on over here?
Hello. Salmon three-way.
This is the best dish here.
Yeah. Thank you.
Ginger.
No, thank you.
And just pork.
Mushrooms.
Thank you.
And the cream sauce. Mashed potatoes is fantastic.
Thank you.
Wow. This is so good.
Enjoy your dinner.
Here's the opened sofa bed. Looks pretty big. It almost looks like a queen, actually. I think it's a queen size. Not a full. Yeah, looks like a queen size. Gonna order some Grand Lux to go take it to the room.
Here is the Cobb salad, chicken on the side, and the eggs any way you want it with hash browns. Three eggs. The meal from the food that we got from Grand Lux, the ranch, their Caesar dressing, everything was fantastic.
That was really, really good.
I really am gonna miss this Mirage the way it is. The stupid Hard Rock taking over and changing this to a huge guitar, electric guitar. Come on. Such a great feeling to be here. You know, there's places where you see on paper and video that seem better. But there's a thing that's called feeling when you're there that doesn't come across. This is one of those places where it doesn't come across through video or on paper, but this is such a special feeling of the Mirage. Bellagio is also one of them. A special feeling. I know it is seen as really nice and stuff, but let's say, for example, compared to the Venetian. On paper, Venetian has a suite, all suite rooms, so the bigger rooms and the shop area and all that stuff. So on paper and maybe through video, it looks like it's more luxurious than the Bellagio, but the feeling of being at the Bellagio and coming back to the room there and back to the hotel is special. It's elevated that you don't get through video or on paper compared to the Venetian. So Bellagio is still my number one. Venetian is a beautiful place to stay, but Bellagio is where you really want to be, where your home base, you want your home base to be. Even though the room is smaller and all that. And Mirage is the other one, the budget one that you want to be. It's a special feeling here. Look at the disgusting thing they did to Treasure Island. See the sign? I'm gonna insert the sign of what it actually used to be when it was themed to pirates. And now look what they did. And this is the same thing they're gonna do to Mirage. Gonna de-theme it into a disgusting guitar. It is very nice in here, but I do like the casino area better, the Bellagio, than here. Here it's very loud and very just like square. No exploration, you know, not much of that to it. Of course, there's the Palazzo that's connected, but still, the feeling is much more refined and luxurious in Bellagio. Feels so good to be back in the room. Well, this is the end of my trip. Venetian is wonderful, it really is. Bellagio is still my number one. The room is fantastic here. Bed is a little less comfortable than, especially the couch sucks. But the bed is less comfortable than the Bellagio's. I am making this Persian green rice, which is fantastic. My leftover three-way salmon from last night at Grand Lux. It was a lot of food. And I'm making, here's that green rice that I'm making. Oh yeah, basmati. Pool's always been crowded. It looks like this place needs bigger pools or more pools, or I know there's other pools too, and those are crowded too, the Palazzo side. But been fantastic over here. Had a wonderful time. So blessed to enjoy these wonderful hotels. I love staying at hotels. This would be let me see on my list. Bellagio's number one. Wynn and Venetian. I think I got to give it up to the Venetian because the location's a little closer to the strip, like the on the strip, a little closer to the center. And it has the Grand Lux 24 hour, which is huge, right downstairs. And those prices are really reasonable. Room is fantastic. Wynn would be third. So it'll be one Bellagio, two Venetian, three Wynn. And then as far as budget hotels are concerned, I think I still got to give it to the Mirage, number one, and then Paris, number two. Very close to each other. Paris Center Strip is a little better, but Mirage, after going back in there, it just feels so much special. But I mean, that's not going to be a thing because Hard Rock is coming instead of it. So Paris is going to be the go-to as far as budget. And if you're going a little cheaper than that, I think Park MGM is a little more cheaper than Paris. So
Park MGM would be the one below that for me. That would be the tier list. Anyways, thank you for joining me. Hope you enjoyed the food and the room. And if you haven't seen the other videos, this is all part of the same trip. And I've been back to back. New York, New York, and then Paris, and then Bellagio, and then here. So hope you guys get a chance to come to the hotel that you desire to be in and enjoy these wonderful places and try not to lose too much money. Hopefully you hit some jackpots. And until next time, which will probably be the Grand Californian, my first time staying there at Disneyland, my DVC points. I think that's going to be next. We'll see. But that's during the holiday season. Actually, no, before that, I'm going to go to Disneyland. Going to renew my annual pass and go back. It's been a few months. And go to the Halloween stuff and eat all the new foods that's been there over the past few months that I haven't been there. So until next time, have a wonderful day.